Hello and welcome to another episode of me painting again. So I'm just throwing some cerulean blue and some ultramarine blue and some titanium white together to make a nice sky for this painting. I've got a few mountains and water. Might even put someone in a boat. Why not? So I'm going to start with some sky. There we go. Ooh, big lump of paint just fell off the brush that was dried. We'll do the sky and then leave areas for mountains, although I've got quite a lot. I've put them all the way down. This is a made up place with a load of mountains. So if you don't have mountains that you can look at, you can always go on Google Maps and look at areas, and go on Pinterest, Google, have a look at mountains, see their structures, and then have a go at trying to develop them into your own painting. Or mountains that you know, if you do live near mountains, you can add them into your painting. So I want a little bit of light in the sky from clouds. A little cloud here and there. Those sort of wispy ones. And behind there. Something like that. The lighter blue down at this part near the horizon, it gets a bit lighter. Okay, so I'm going to start putting in these distant mounds. I'm going to use a bit of blue, a little bit of the vermilion red. More of that blue. That's not bad. Might try that for our distant mountains. Got a few of these. Get a bit more blue and white in it, really, for this one here. Get a bit darker. Wipe my brush quickly. Take the light off my brush, basically. Go a little bit darker. I'm gonna get this sort of the darker side. More blue in it. something like that. And I had another one behind it, like here. It went sort of... there. This is all very distant. Can even throw a bit of brown in it just to bring that forward a bit in front of that one. Okay, and then I'm gonna throw some brown into some, make a darker mountain colour now. Brown, blue, red. And I'll start building this up a bit. Need this mountain to go like that to get the shapes that I want. I do enjoy painting landscapes. They are good fun, aren't they? Just making up stuff and creating, using nature, but then being a bit creative at the same time. It is enjoyable. So I'm going to throw in a bit of green here as well. A bit of trees growing up here. Places. Starting with that dark again, like I didn't do normally now. Use a bit of dark and then you can bring in the light afterwards. It's a good way of a good way of developing a painting, but putting all your dark in first and then thinking about it and then add a little bit of light, then a bit more light until you worked it out, and you can add even more. So we'll let that dry a little bit. I'm gonna get a bit of ultramarine blue. Ultramarine in with this mountain colour. I want to darken some of these areas here. That area there and some sort of down here. Just want to add this hint of blue in this. We need a, we're going to have water along here as well. We're going to need some nice trees in front. So what I'm going to use is that nice dark colour, that green. Got a little bit of bluey brown, sap green. Nice dark green. Start creating the area where there's trees. pushing that brush up a little bit. I just turn my page, so I find it easier if I do it like that, then I can bring it towards me, flatten out some of the land. Like that. Trap it back under my book. I've got like a stack of books up there. I use that to hold my page. So there we go. We'll let that dry off a little bit, and well, while we're thinking about what we're gonna do next, I'm gonna grab another brush, create like a yellow and white highlight, a little yellow ochre. And some white. Be all sunlight. Might get a tiny bit of red in that as well. So, think about the light is coming this way, and it's the way I see it, and I'm gonna put in some light going light on here. Use my finger to just smudge it a little bit to take away some of the brightness. That rock. When you're doing yours, you can choose where you want your light to have hit. Could go like that. Maybe a little bit on this. It's getting a little bit, not too much. Sometimes it's a good idea to do multiple brightnesses and then you can start. I'll show you what I mean. This is, I've just gone into a little bit of mountain mix, same colour. This is my start. Creating all this detail. I'll do more detail on this one. It's closer, you see a bit more. So this is the first pass if you want. I did this with my waterfalls as well. It just gives you a chance to think about it, and then when you've worked it out, then you can go back and go and put on a bit more brightness. This area here, we're gonna have some right area there. Behind that. Okay. So now I can go back with my yellow ochre and white. And then I can go a bit lighter and pick out a few more of these areas that I want. Something like that. You can start pulling it across the way where you want it to go and make your little details. I'm gonna have my rock sort of looking like that. I might have a chunk here as well, sort of there. Something like that. And I can get a bit of that sky colour. A little bit of blue, a little bit of the mountain mix, a little bit dark. I can break up this. Yeah, something like that. Quite liking that. Now, what I'm going to do I'm going to mist a little bit here. Just a little bit of blue and white. I'm just putting that over, just misting things a bit, giving it a bit of atmosphere. I might have a few tree tops showing as well. Bit of green and yellow. Kind of imagine it sort of going. Yeah, I want them to go downwards like that. indication of a lot of trees. You up here as well. Got a little bit lighter, maybe there's some that have got a bit more light on them. You would get some that got that are capturing more light than others, wouldn't you? Anyway, that'll do me. Looks pretty good. I always think to myself, would I want to go there? I always think, yes. This would look like it'd be a great place to go, wouldn't it? We'll have an adventure. Visiting. Just picking up a bit of green. Gonna put in some trees here. Go a little bit bigger with the trees here, so a bit closer. Using that mist that I put in behind as a separator, so you can see the shapes of some of these trees. I'm gonna use some of this to go in the water as well. Okay, so what I might do next is start putting in a little bit of a colour for the water. A bit of green, a bit of blue. Blue, a bit of white. I can really go for this. Water. to bring that across here. Okay, now I might put some light on some of these trees. And improve the water a little bit, yeah, make it a little bit lighter. I could put some indication of it's quite warm today. Forgot about that. Have to make sure my palette has got a bit of I got this idea of maybe there would be indication of mountain reflection. I'll just put hints of it in. Just have a little bit of that mountain colour in the water. So, I want to lighten some of the trees. I'm going to need a small brush to do it. And some yellow and green. Some of these trees, like this one here. You can some of these give them a bit of light. A little bit of that in the water. Why not? Just getting some of these a bit more light, because it has got a little bit dark there. You can spend a long time putting in each tree. You can have light, more light on the top of them, more the bottom of them, doesn't really matter. Depends on your design, how you want it to look. Just adds a little something to the painting, these little details. So I'm going to get this water moving a little bit as well. I'm going to get some white and blue. Some of this going across. Some of those reflections will show through and it will work quite nice. I want a bit more light on this water. Okay, so now, I could miss that out and send that further back if I wanted, and I could build up some of these trees even. I might do that, I might have some bigger trees, using a bit of dark. Bit of light on that one side. Just adding these little details. bit more light there. Okay. That'll do. Now I want to put a boat on. So I'll give it a yellow ochre. Sienna, yellow ochre. Let's have a boat about here. So I'll go in. And I need to reflect it as well. Darker at the back of the boat. Have a an engine, maybe we'll use. Blue and white. A bit of a red and yellow ochre mix for the person can be sat about there. He's got his sat there. A reflection. If you can see that, it does reflect a little bit. Just fill that in a bit better. Knees off. Maybe you can see some of the stuff he's got in the boat there. Yeah, just make it up. Get a little bit of white and blue, and I can start pushing the water a little bit along him. Just go in a bit. Going across. Where's he going? Who knows? He's on his way. Something like that. And then what I might do, just sort of imagine there's a area this side, and we can have like sort of a dark green going in front. Something like that. And then maybe there's a bit that comes there. Kind of frame it if I wanted to, with all this from this side. This side of the bank where the artist was stood. I can put in a few to really like that. Wants to be a little darker. Don't want it to be too light, but I don't want it to be completely dark. Tap it away a little bit. Give some of these trees a bit more highlight again. Might have a little bit of light hitting the front of his boat as well. So So it's a bit lighter there. Maybe on the side of him as well. A bit more light in there. And just keep coming back, line dark, line dark, line dark. And but yeah. It's quite a fun painting. You could do this one, no problem. You could do a indication of trees and the light at the top. I think I'll call this one finished. I could add a bit of light here. But yeah, he's on his way. Anyway. I could keep going for hours. That's the thing about painting. Once you get it started, you're like, oh, I could do this, I could do that, I could start melting some of this green into the water here. And you can just... you can just keep going and going and going. But I quite like this little painting. It's quite a fun one. It's not as dramatic as some of the others I've done. It's just got a nice flow to it. Maybe there'll be a little bit of a bird. I'll stop here. Couple of them. Maybe you would have some little ones in the water as well. They didn't really look right. Just adding little bits of flow here and there. I think I'll call that one finished. So thanks very much for watching this one, and I'll see you at another one. Cheers, bye.